Okay, guys. We're gonna be watching 1.5 Genshin Impact patch official live stream, and I really hope that we're gonna be able to find out about when we're gonna be getting the rerun banner, when we're gonna be getting the Eula banner. So here we go. Let's see how it goes. You know the big brain for this? Paimon says hello, travelers. Oh, she's trying to be really, really cute. Her name is Kim Ga-ryong. Hello. 1.5 특별 방송에 참여하게 돼서 영광이에요. Oh, they have this the other way around now. Last time we only had Chinese live stream with a subtitle, but this time it's back to the Korean voice. So we're gonna have Zong, Lee, Paimon, and Traveler voice actors. So they're happy that they are able to talk to us again. 1.5 버전의 특별 게스트인 And our special guest is Zong Lee. And Paimon says,
안녕하세요.
Say hi real quick.
네, 저는 종료 더빙을 맡고 있는 성우 표영재입니다. 1.5 버전의 특별 방송이 드디어 리월에서 시작된다고 하는데요. 신규 버전의 정보를 전달하는 중요한 역할을 맡게 된 만큼 여러분의 기대를 저버릴 수 없겠죠? 이번 리월 담화에선 1.5 버전의 따끈따끈한 최신 정보가 가득합니다. 그리고 플레이스테이션 5 버전도 4월 28일 날 1.5 버전과 함께 출시된다고 하니까
18th, we're going to have a PS5 version.
그럼 이제 빨리 새로운 버전의 PV를 만나 볼까요?
PS5. And we're going to take a look at the PV.
인연이 닿는다면 다시 만나게 될 거야.
사원이 죽는가? 바구니 메고 도깨비 같은 걸 든 사람들이 여기
지나갔어. Yes, Geo Daddy.
네가 말한 거랑 비슷해. 그리고 맨 앞에 비틀거리는 여자애도 한 명 있었어요.
야타 용왕은 나야. 원소 결정에서 태어나 대지의 힘과 기억을 이어받은 불로불사의 존재라.
Is that the new juvie shop? Yo, what is that? Is that a grown-up plea? And that's a cryo hypostasis. Yanfei. Oh my, we're gonna get a lot of characters here. And is that Eula? Oh my god, you know what I really love about this PV? Music is epic! Alright, I'm pulling for this Eula, okay? I'm gonna go for C6. She looks pretty, not gonna lie.
자, 다 됐다. 이 속세의 주전자가 선물이란다.
The one on the bottom, it says that this is a co-op mode that is still being under development.
이 할미가 부른 작은 녀석이 언제나 그 안에서 너희를 기다리고 있을 테니 속세의 주전자와 관련된 건 그 친구에게 물어보면 된단다.
And it is a housing system. Oh my god. This is very nice. I suck at like decorating stuff, but this is going to be my next level contents. We're gonna have like a contest where you would probably decorate your place, and then we will raid it. Yep, house. Oh my god, it looks so pretty. Oh my god, I absolutely love this system, man. I'm so glad they came up with this system. I mean, who cares about no PvP system, right? No PvP? Yeah. It kind of drives those competitive people away from Genshin Impact, but this is going to bring a lot more kinds of people who wants to play Genshin Impact just for this. Yeah, we can just raid the house. And this is going to be the new contents. April 28th. Sorry, probably I said April 18th, but April 28th for the PS5 version as well. That's an animal that you can purchase. And then you can also visit their world. Their house, I mean. And then these are events. To fill in the blanks. It says that plunge attack challenge. Okay. What are you doing? What is this? You're disguised as a freaking barrel. Oh, this is a hide and seek, right? Wow. You run around with a box. It says overflowing mastery. Oh, overflowing mastery, that kind of thing. I believe that's a times 2 drop for, right? And they are new artifacts. The one... That was too fast. Let me quickly go back and take a look at these. 2 sets. This is going to give you 20% HP. 4 sets. When your elemental skill hits the opponent, in the party, all the characters will gain 20% attack. They're going to get 30% shield strength. It's going to last for three seconds. And then this effect will proc every time. Sorry, once in 0.5 seconds. And even if the characters using this artifact is not in the field, it still works. And this one is 2 set. Your physical, this is a physical set, right? 2-piece, you do 25% extra physical damage. 4 set, when your elemental skill hits the opponent, your attack goes up by 9%. Lasts for 7 seconds. It stacks up to 2 times. 0.5 times. Once every 0.3 times. And then when you get... Oh my god, when you get the full stacks, you're gonna get the 100% increase. So, here. So when you get 2 stacks, right, you're gonna get 18% attack, and this is gonna be 50% physical damage. So I was maybe thinking, like, maybe 2-piece bloodstain and new artifact, but then if 4-set allows you to have 100%, like, times 2, when you get the max stack, right, this is gonna be good. Okay, you know what I can do here? I can make the play speed to be 1.5 because this is a review, right? We can make it real quick. Okay, this is the new code. I'm gonna type it up for you guys. Okay, Tena, shut up. Here. FS6SU367M279. This is the code. And I can probably demonstrate that you can get them. Go to settings, go to account, go to redeem code, copy paste. Yep, cock. All right, we got it. Okay, when we're watching the PV, we have to put the play speed to be normal. It says that this is still under being development, so yeah. Those are the fireballs. Oh my god, Eula. Eula, you are so sexy. She is gorgeous. She's... I don't know why, but why are the cryo characters so beautiful? Well, besides Kaya, there's... Wow, that is slick. Alright, we can take a look at her skills. Let's speedrun this. Paimon keeps on saying that she looks so beautiful. We can move on to their skills. Okay, okay. So her elemental skills.
유라의 원소 전투 스킬인 얼음 파도의 와류는 짧은 터치와 홀드가 각각 다른 효과를 가지고
있습니다. There's a hold skill and a tap skill.
냉혹한 마음을 통해 경직 저항력과 방어력이 증가하고 홀드하여 냉혹한 마음을 사용하면 적의 물리 내성과 얼음 원소 내성을 감소시킵니다.
Hold E brings down their res for physical and cryo. Oh my god. She is really really good. And her Q
광검으로 보스나 정의 몬스터에게 대응할 수 있어요. 처음 검을 휘둘러 적에게 피해를 입히는 것 외에 빛의 검이 생성되는데 유라의 평타나 원소 스킬 공격으로 적에게 피해를 입히면 이 빛의 검에 일정한 에너지가 쌓이고 마지막 순간에 맹렬한 폭발을 일으키죠.
So after you use Q, there's gonna be a sword of light, and as you attack. With the elemental skill, with your auto attacks, the energy will get stacked to that sort of light. And then, at the end, it will explode. Kaya gender bent. No. And this is gonna be a 4-star character, yes? This is a Ningguang Pyro Edition, yeah? Alright, Yanfei. 2월 법률의
변천과 연비는 몇 안 되는 손님 선배들처럼 손님들의
머리. Let's move on to the elemental skill.
복잡한 법조문을 진지하게 분석하는 모습에선 일종의 반전 매력도 느낄 수 있죠.
뿔이 있으면 잠잘 때 불편하지 않을까.
연비는 전투에서 법구를 사용하고 불원소 신의 눈을 가지고 있어요. 연비의 일반 공격, 원소 전투 스킬인 단홍의 계약, 원소 폭발인 계약 성립 모두 단홍 지인이라는 특수 효과를 부여해요. 단홍 지인은 연비의 스태미나 소모를 감소시키고 강공격 시 단홍 지인을 소모해 강공격 범위와 피해를 강화할 수 있어요.
연비 옆에 있는 그 도장.
So they're saying that when you're using like all those elemental skills and burst skills, you get this passive so that it lets you spend less stamina as you attack with
네 맞아요.
As you do your charge attacks with your Yanfei.
연비는 아주 특별한 사이예요. 뛰어난 여기사와 통통 튀는 매력의 신수가 만나면 어떤 재밌는 일이 생길까요?
Oh, no, her attack is not test, guys. This is 1.5 times so that we can move on to the next redeem code.
기다려볼까요? 새로운 캐릭터에 대한 소개는 여기까지 하죠. 그럼 이어서 매 방송마다 여러분들이 가장 기다리는 주제에 대해서 얘기해 볼 시간이에요.
So we're going to talk about something that we're really interested in every stream.
네, 맞아요. 새로운 캐릭터를 보고 나면 바로 나올 다음 질문은
그래서 언제 뽑을 수 있나요? 빨리.
So when are we going to be able to find out? Okay, when are we going to get them?
유라가 차례로 이벤트 기원에 등장할 예정이에요.
Oh no, they say that it's going to be Zhongli and then Yula.
또 다른 새 캐릭터인 연비 역시 사냐의 시조 이벤트 기원에 등장하고 획득 확률도 상승해요.
자세한 기원 시간은 추후에 나올 공지에서 확인하실 수 있습니다.
여러분들이 오래 기다
Okay, they usually they give us a date, but then it always came they kind of showed us the character in the order, right? So it's probably going to be Zhongli and Yula. That's a little disappointing, but that kind of makes sense because that would allow us to go for Zhongli and then Yula. They're going to get the most money out of it. Because if you get Yula and then Zhongli, you're going to spend too much money, right? On Yula first, and then you'll be like, oh no, I'm broke. But then if it's the other way around, you spend money on Zhongli, and then after you see Yula, you're like, okay, I don't have money. I'm going to sell my kidney, you know?
내리셨을 새로운 오성 양손검과 새로운 성염물 두 종류 역시 1.5 버전에서 공개된다고 하는데요.
This artifact, this new artifact will come out in
1.5. 맞아요. 새
오성에서 성염물을 획득할 수 있는 방법 역시 1.5 버전의 새로운 축성 비결.
And then there's going to be a new domain right here by the dragon spine, and that's going to drop those.
산등성의 파수꾼에서 확인하실 수 있습니다. 이 새로운 비경은 몬드와 리월의 경계에 생길 예정이랍니다. 여러분 모두 비경 도전을 완료하고 새로운 성염물을 획득해 보세요.
드디어 여기에 새로운 워프 포인트가 생기는군요. 그전엔 여기 기어 올라가는 게 너무 귀찮았거든요. 캐릭터들에게 새로운 아이템을 제공할 뿐만 아니라 캐릭터 스토리와 관련된 업데이트도 준비가 되어 있는데.
And there's going to be a story update for Diona and Noel.
1.5 버전 업데이트 완료 후 디오나 초대 이벤트와 노엘의 초대 이벤트 제2장도 개방될 예정이에요. 그리고 종료의 전설 임무 제2장 유라의 전설.
Well, we're going to get another story quest for Zhongli and then another one. Well, sorry, not another one. But the new one for Eula, of course.
차례대로 개방되니까 여러분들 모두 임무 알림에 신경
써주세요.
Okay. 1.4 버전의 초대 이벤트는 다들 재밌게 즐기셨나요? 저도 개인적으로 초대 이벤트처럼 모든 대사의 음성이 지원되고 다양한 엔딩이 있는 에피소드들을 많이 즐기고 싶어요. 캐릭터의 개성도 잘 드러나면서 캐릭터와 정까지 드니까요.
네, 여러분들이 방금 종료. 그러니까 저에 대해서 얘기했는데 제가 종료로서 작은 비밀을 하나 말씀드릴게요. 종료랑 뭔가 아주 깊은 인연이 있어 보이는 야타 용왕은 종료의 전설인 모제 2장에서 정식으로 등장할 거예요.
이미 은퇴한 보통 사람인 종료도 뭔가 해야 할 일이 엄청 많아 보이네요.
개화꽃을
They're saying some stuff in Korean. Because I didn't play Genshin Impact in Korean, I don't know what he just talked about. But then he said there's something related to... I don't know the word in English. I'm so sorry about that. But they say that something that you might be wondering about Zhongli will be open in the second story quest. So we'll find out about those.
예 친구와 함께 뱃놀이를 가고 싶으나 예 친구를 오늘 다시 만나니 마음에 새.
Because we're watching this in a 1.5 times story, the speed. This is gonna be the fastest stream out there. Where is our second code?
기운들만의 힘을 가졌는지 함께 볼까요?
Okay, normal speed. We watched this earlier, right? That's a lot of Zhongli pillars, right? That's like 8. That's a lot of Zhongli pillars. And then again, this is being developed right now. We're gonna get the Azdaha, a new monster. Another Geo monster?
야타용왕은 아니겠지?
그러게요. 그 복룡목은 바로 당시 야타용왕이 진압된 장소거든요. 이번에 그가 일으킨 소동은 리월에게도 커다란 위협이 되겠죠. 여러분이 도전하시게 될 보스인 이 야타용왕은 전투 도중 자신의 원소를 교체할 수 있어서 비주얼적인 효과가 아주 대단할 겁니다.
야타용왕이 원소를 교체하면
They say that when they're in the battle, they should be able to change their elements.
비경 내 환경도 바뀐다고 해요.
And also, as they change their elements, the environment is going to be changed as well.
비경왕이 엄청 큰데 나무 밑에 이렇게 신기한 동굴이 숨겨져 있을 줄은 몰랐어요.
맞아요.
이번엔 야타 외에 무상 시리즈 보스에도 새로운 멤버가 추가됐다고. 바로 무상의 얼음.
Oh my god. The cryo hypostasis. To be honest, I really don't like hypostasis series because it takes a lot of time for you to kill them, right? Well, most of all, I hate Oceanid so much.
When I went to the castle, I thought there was a secret around this area. There was also a mountain of ice.
무상의 얼음 또한 자기만의 독특한 전투 방식이 있는데요. 위기의 순간 무상의 얼음은 보호막 속으로 들어가서 자신을 보호하고 HP를 회복하는
And of course this hypostasis when their HP goes below certain percentage then they're going to have that finishing
버전에서 만났던 멋있는 심연 사원을 기억하시죠? 이번 버전에선 심연에서 온 또 다른 정의 몬스터 심연 봉독자와도 만나게 될 거예요.
And then another new monster In Abyss. Can we please get more Abyss floors?
심연 사도가 근거리 자객이면 심연 봉독자는 원거리 법사 느낌이 강한데요. 하나는 물이고 하나는 번개라니 재밌는 조합이네요.
Okay. Sorry about that. It's not. They didn't really say it's for abyss floors, but This is another monster. Abyss Herald, and this is Abyss Lector. A new monster. So probably they will show up in a quest. Unless they tell me about Abyss Floors, I'll tell you.
번개의 힘을 사용하는 이 법사의 일부 공격은 캐릭터의 원소 에너지를 잃게 할 수도 있어서 잘 피해야 합니다.
Like all the time, this electro attack from this monster, it will deplete your energy. So you need to be aware of that and you need to dodge those.
네, 그럼 신규 몬스터에 관한 소개는 여기까지.
And that's it for all the new monsters. And we will probably get the new coupon. Where's the coupon?
속세 주전자가 추가됩니다.
Okay, this is a new system they're gonna show us.
리월의 위기가 일단락된 뒤 선인들은 계속 여행자 여러분들을 생각하고 있었다고 해요. 집도 없이 노숙하는 이방의 여행자가 리월.
Okay, so all those adeptees or adeptus in Liyue were thinking about us because we had to travel around without home. No, it's because of Staff of Homa that made us homeless. But here we go.
선물로 주겠다고 합니다. 연비도 이 주전자 만드는.
This is the housing system.
이 작은 찻 주전자가 우리 위해 준비한 보금자리라고? 이 코딱지만한 데를 어떻게 들어가? 난 절대 못 들어가. 흠칫뿡.
리월 선인들은 사만 오현의 능력이 있어. 찻 주전자 속에 선계를 만드는 것쯤은 선인에게 식은 줄 먹이지.
Okay, so remember when one of the grandma NPC made us go into the pot? That's probably the same thing.
오는 모습이 엄청 귀엽다.
주전자 정령은 아주 중요한 역할을 하는데요.
So you collect those
이 정령과 신뢰를 쌓아 보상을 얻고 주전자 내 새로운
They say that if you build friendship with this adeptus then they're going to let us
세금할 수 있습니다.
They're going to let us unlock
청옥섬, 취대봉 그리고
the environments
세 가지 형태의 선계가 있는데 이걸 전부 해금하려면 열심히 신뢰 등급을 쌓아야겠죠?
어떻게 해야 신뢰를 쌓을 수 있을까요?
This is gonna be really, really good.
장식품을 하나 만들 때마다 주전자 정령과의 신뢰도가 올라갑니다. 주전자 정령 포롱이의 도움으로 다양한 경로를 통해
They say that if you collect currencies and start making those housing materials, then you build friendship with other people.
장식품 도면을 얻을 수 있으며 필요한 재료를 모으고 제작을 완료하면 자신만의 따뜻한 집을 만들 수 있죠.
And then you collect materials as well.
물론 포롱이한테 사용 가능한 장식품을 직접 구매할 수 있습니다.
Okay, let me wrap that up. Sorry. To create something to decorate your house, you're going to have to collect the materials. And then about the currencies, I'll tell you.
공간이 생긴 거나 마찬가지니 어떻게 꾸밀지 잘 고민해 보는 게 좋겠어요. 방 안에 아무것도 없이 텅 비어 있으면 집처럼 느껴지지 않을 테니까요. 그리고 다른 친구의 주전자에 가서 어떻게 꾸며 볼지 같이 이야기해 볼 수도 있습니다.
And then you can go to other people's world or their house and talk about how you would be decorating the world or a house or their I don't know, whatever.
그래야 더 자유롭게 꾸밀 수 있으니까요.
They say that the reason why this is so big it's because they wanted to give us more freedom to decorate.
너무 작으면
That's really nice because usually have you ever seen those games where they had like small island to decorate? It's not fun, right? And it's really easy to like copy paste. And you don't like it when people just copy your work, right? If it's so big, it's going to be really hard for you to copy your stuff and then you're going to be able to be more creative.
주전자의 선계 설력이 올라가고 더 많은
Okay, have you seen the symbol on this page? Where did it go? Let me show you quickly. Right here. When you make materials for a decoration, right here. You see this, right? So as you make those, you get those friendship points. That friendship point will allow you... to get the currencies.
선계 화폐가 바로 주전자 속에서 사용되는 특수 화폐인 셈이죠.
And those currencies can be used to buy these kind of things. You can get the resin, you can get the hero's weight, you can get the enhancement ores, mora. I don't know what these two are, but yeah, they also give you the materials. That's really good.
가끔 귀한 물건을 가지고 오는 여행하는 주전자 정령도 나타나니 꼭 확인해 보세요.
They say that there sometimes is an NPC that shows you those limited stuff. Like you could buy, I believe these are for... Isn't that... Okay, that's for housing. That's for housing.
그럼 지금은 실외와 실내 모두 꾸밀 수 있는 거네요?
So you can decorate stuff in the house and outside. Wow.
선인의 설력이 들어 있으니 앞으로
This is a banger.
다양한 기능이 추가될 겁니다. 일시적인 게 아닌 계속해서 유지될 시스템이니 속세의 주전자가
They say that this is going to be in the game forever, so don't worry. Because sometimes they just go away, right? It kind of sucks. All right, there is the redeem code. That's a 4BNSD3675J8D. Here you go. There's a second redeem code. And then we're gonna go ahead and redeem the second one. I'll make sure that it works. Yep, it works. It works.
Okay, I need to...
Alright, we're gonna move on.
번째 이벤트는 바로
to the next topic.
판 서론입니다. 수메르에서 온 한 학자가
okay, a new event.
짐에게 열매 조각을 수집해 달라고 부탁하는데.
It says that they ask us to collect the stuff from ley lines.
통해서 아주 신비로운 고대 유물 전도 원판을 얻게 됩니다. 이 원판은 짐에게 열매 조각을 가동시켜서 다양한 버프 효과를 일으키죠.
And then you use those materials that you get from the ley lines and put it inside of the this tablet thing. And then you get those buffs. As you complete the tablet, you get like a buff for your elemental skills, your auto attacks.
최대 3명의 친구의 고레벨 캐릭터로 구동력을 높일 수 있습니다. 맞습니다. 물론 짐에게
And then you can also use your friends to buff more stuff.
열매 조각을 얻는 게 쉽지만은 않겠죠. 티바트 세계의 다양한 생물들도 이 조각을 빼앗으려고 할 테니까요. 그러니까 먼저 주변 위협을 제거해야지만
So you kill those monsters basically and then you get that You get this. Basically. And then you get those currencies.
짐에게 열매로 인해 뒤틀려버린 비경에도 도전을 진행할 수 있습니다.
And then also you can
비경이 있는데 비경마다 짐에게 이상 상황이 다 다르죠.
You can challenge to the domains.
우상의 교향시와 아주 비슷합니다.
And then each of the domains give you 60 pyramidems, which is good. Just like what is it called?
더 높은 도전 점수를
Just like Hypostasis Harmony. You guys remember that?
모두 상점에서 보상을
You can choose the difficulties.
부서진 열매 데이터를 얻게 됩니다.
여기서 잠깐 이번 이벤트에서 부서진
열매 You can buy a crown, you can buy talent materials just like any other events. And then you can get Diona for free. Oh my god. Yes.
이 이벤트는 기존에 이로 소개해 드릴 이벤트는
And then the plunge attack challenge.
이 이벤트는 기존의 이벤트들과 많이 다른데요.
They say that it's gonna be a different than the other events that they had before.
테마의 스테이지 중 시스템이 지정한 체험 캐릭터만 사용할 수 있으며
They say that they you only can play on a character that the system chooses you to.
소 공명이 일어나지 않습니다. 그리고
And there is no elemental resonance.
배낭 속의 음식 등도 사용이 제한되죠.
And then you cannot use any food. And then, if I were to translate some of the missions here, it says that you have to. Wait, I don't understand. I think these are related to the events, and it says that you kill 10 monsters with barriers on, and it says get hit less than 30 times. This one says beat the game with more than 6 minutes left on the timer. So stuff like that.
되게 어려울 것 같은데요.
대신 도전하기 전에. 이번 스테이지에 나오게 될 몬스터, 필요한 힌트, 그리고 완료해야 할 소소한 임무를 미리 확인한 뒤 파티를 더 알맞게
So, you know, those kind of things may look challenging, right? Okay, so these are trial characters. They're all level 80s, and that's not really stuff that you have. So even if you are F2P, you can still choose those characters. They're mostly F2P, there's Kaching, there's Mona, there's Albedo, but still, it's always nice to use 5-star characters. And they say that it may be a little challenging because especially for whales like me. I have those nice weapons, nice characters. So if I use those weaker characters, it's going to be more challenging. But then beforehand, we can see what we need to know about the domain. We can choose the characters and go. So it says that you, like, all your characters would get 300 elemental mastery. And then it says when a character creates elemental reactions, there's gonna be a shock to a place where there was a reaction, and then that's gonna happen once in one second. Stuff like that.
있을 거예요. 시련의 비경에서 저희가 완료해야 할 임무는 바로 제한 시간 안에 잠들어 있는 고대 룬 문자 세 개를 찾아 활성화한 뒤.
So what you need to do in this domain is that you need to activate those sleeping. Well, they say sleeping, but I would say the ancient symbol that was sealed. You break that and then kill those monsters. That's what you need to do.
개방하는 겁니다. 시련 중엔 다양한 버프를 부여하는.
And then during the domain, you'll be able to see a lot of buffs.
난이도를 낮추죠.
And that's gonna help you clear this domain a little bit better.
그 외에 도전자의 침입으로 인해 자동 발동된 섬멸포도 존재하는데 알맞은 원소 공격으로 일시적인 그로기 상태가 됩니다.
잘 고민해보고 전략을.
They just said that it doesn't show in the video, but then they said that there's gonna be a guardian that would be awake because of the intruders, which is you guys, and you can, with the right elements, you can nullify them, just like how you would like shoot ring guards in the eye to nullify them, right? So probably those are what they're talking about.
하지만 원석과 모라가 기다리고 있으니 어떤 시련도 문제 없죠.
But then again, we get those rewards, so it's always a good thing.
이번 이벤트엔 모두에게 너무나도 익숙한 그 이상한 추추족이 등장합니다. 최근에 무슨 영문인지 이 이상한 추추족이 상로에 빈번히 출몰하고 있다고 해요. 아무래도 놈에게 본때를 보여줘야 할 것 같군요.
They just mentioned that there's going to be a lot of way literals.
근데 이 all of a sudden. 추추족을 찾는 건 쉬운 일이 아니에요.
And they have mentioned that it is really hard for you to locate way literals.
평소에
yes.
어디 있는지도 모르니까 이번엔 도움이 좀 필요할 것 같아요.
다들 엘라 머스크라고 하는 그 추추어 전문가 기억하시죠? 이번엔 그녀가 준 추추어 핸드북을 이용해서 의사소통이 가능한 추추족과의 교류를 통해 이상한 추추족이 출몰하는 장소를 알아낸 뒤 그를 혼내주러 가야 하죠.
Okay, I thought it might be a little help for those of us who wants to kill Wade Illiterals, but it seems like an event where you would interact with Ella Musk. Do you guys remember her? She is going to give you a handbook, and then you're going to be able to interact with the Wade Illiteral. And this is going to be a temporary event. You talk to the Choo Choo guy. Oh, sorry, the Illiteral. Sorry, dude. They call that Choo Choo in Korean, so that kind of threw me off. Isn't it more cute to call them choo-choo instead of literals?
안 그러면 핸드북을 열 때마다 무심이다. 핸드북을 닫을 때 무심이샤. 다시 핸드북을 열 때
무심하게를
했군. 근데 이 핸드북이 얼마나 유용할지는 의문이야. 왜냐면 앞면에 이 책은 추추어로 급하게 교류가 필요한 상황에 참고용으로만 쓰이니 결과는 책임질 수 없음이라고 적혀 있거든.
Okay, so like you go to a place, you choose the time. Probably this guy chose night then a day, and then it says that you have to kill Wei Illiteral within a certain time.
말 잘못했다가 위험한 일이 생기진 않겠죠?
그럴 땐 okay. 힘으로 설득할 면과 원석 등의 보상을 획득할 수 있으니.
And then from that event, you can get. I believe these are four housings, so that's good. And then of course you get Primos, Moras, and Heroes Wit.
이제 오늘의 마지막 이벤트를 소개해요.
And this is going to be the last event that they're going to tell us.
바람의 행방이라고 하는 미니 게임입니다.
Oh, it's the mini game.
쉽게 말해서 숨바꼭질과 아주 비슷한데요.
Hide and seek.
이 미니 게임은 과거의 귀족과 이에 반항하던 평민의 대결에서 비롯된 거라고 해요. 지금이야 그렇게 무거운 의미가 담겨 있지 않지만 헌터와 레인저라는 두 진영은 그대로 전해져 내려왔죠. 오, 친구들과 다인모드로 숨바꼭질한 여행자님들 계시던데 이 게임도 같은 형식인가요? 네, 기존의 숨바꼭질에 규칙을 추가해서 변형을 좀 시켰다고 해요. 매칭 시 랜덤으로.
Guys, didn't you guys hear me talking about how we are supposed to have like a? It would be really nice to have a hide and seek system in Genshin Impact. Did you guys hear me saying that? I'm a fucking genius. I think I need to be hired. I need to be hired.
레인저와 헌터 진영으로 나뉘어지는데 레인저가 숨으면 헌터가 찾는 방식이죠. 하지만 단순히 숨고 쫓기만 하는 건 아닙니다. 양측 모두 다양한 바람의 비수를 선택해서 승부를 벌일 수 있어요. 레인저는 은신, 위장, 미끼 배치 같은 스킬이 있는 반면 헌터는 레인저를 간파하고 탐지하는 것에 포커스가 맞춰져 있죠.
So in this game, you can have like a role there. So like as a hunter, you can like wait. What did they say about the hunter?
다양한 바람의 비수를 선택해서 승부를 벌일 수 있어요. 레인저는 은신,
Ranger?
위장, 미끼
can camouflage. They can hide.
같은 스킬이 있는 반면 헌터는 레인저를 간파하고 탐지.
And as the guy who needs to catch them. You can sense them with a thing. What is it called? What is this compass thing? Whenever there's like a like in between the games, there would be a random buff.
획득한 후에는 강력한 가호 비수를 위해 에너지를 충전할 수 있습니다.
이 미니 게임은 전부 월드에서 진행되니까
They probably said something about enhancing the skills, but I'm not so sure. They use a lot of nice Chinese words that I don't understand even in Korean.
그리고 게임에 참여하면 행방 코인을 획득할 수 있어요. 이걸로 여러 등급의 보상을 해금할 수 있는데
And of course it gives you Primal Gems, Mora, Hero's Wit, what's it called? Enhancement Ore, Talent Books.
행방 코인이 당일 최대치에 달하면 더 이상 획득할 수 없어요.
네, 여러분이 이 미니게임을 하면서 즐거운 시간을 보냈으면 좋겠습니다. 앞에서 소개한 이벤트 외에 이번 1.5 버전 기간에는 캐릭터 육성에 도움이 되는 마스터리의 격려 이벤트도 있습니다.
오, 전에 진에게 격려라는 이벤트도 있었죠?
The Overflow Mastery is another event they're gonna have somewhere, and they're gonna give you double drop.
드랍되는 건 캐릭터 특성 육성 소재예요. 이벤트 기간에 마스터리의 격려에 도전하면
They didn't exactly say double drop.
두 배 드랍 기회.
Oh yeah, yeah. It's three times, two times. You can do this three times, and that's gonna be a double drop. They just said that.
그렇네요.
Okay.
캐릭터 스킬 레벨업 소재가 부족한 여행자님들은 이번 이벤트를 절대 놓치지 마세요.
All right. And then about the system. Hey guys, do you guys remember the weekly boss? Do you guys remember the weekly boss? Do you guys remember? They're gonna have the resin usage for that. So from 60, it's gonna be 30. Is that right? Did it cost 60? If that's the case, it's gonna be 30. Yes? Okay. And then they say that when you're in co-op mode, the amount of friendship points that you get is gonna be times 2. So when you're playing with your friend and another friend, you get times 2. That makes sense, right? Okay. The third one, it says that before the limited event ends, they give you a reminder. And in the setting, you can change the let me hear about the number 4.
버전에서 진행 중인 시스템 최적화 1.5 버전일까요? 빠질 수 없겠죠? 그럼
Yeah, so you can choose the language pack freely, but you can do it still now.
첫 번째로 최적화되는 부분을 알아볼까요?
Okay. So from 60 now it's 30. Did you guys see that?
퓨어 레진 60 포인트가 필요하잖아요. 이번 업데이트 이후에는 필요한
So I like how they made it to be 3 times only because if there's going to be more weekly bosses, we're still going to have to pay for that 60. You know what I mean? I don't like this. I like how they made it to be half, but I still don't like this. It's only 3 times. For if there's like 4 or 5 or 6 weekly bosses, it's still going to be times it's going to be up to 3 times. Yeah? Let's not get tricked. Thank you for doing this, but it could have been permanent for all the weekly bosses.
한번만 회복하면 모든 주간 보스를 쓸어버릴 수 있겠네요.
맞습니다. 그 후에 다인 모드 상태에서
They didn't say anything about the world bosses, and I have no complaint about that.
캐릭터의 호감도를 획득하면 호감을 알고
Then about the double friendship points, yeah?
네, 다음으로 최적화되는 내용은
기간의
이벤트에 관한 건데요. 1.5 버전에서도 꽤 시스템 콘텐츠
The third one is a reminder.
나날이 커져가는 클라이언트를 손쉽게 줄일 수 있게 된다는 건데요.
이거로 language
언어 옵션에서 기존에 다운로드한 음성팩을 관리할 수
있어요. Oh, you can actually take care of the language pack. If you don't like Japanese media pack, you can delete it because it costs a lot of resource, right? It says that Korean language takes like 2.88 gigabyte. Holy crap. Okay, we need those. Thank you, thank you. And that's it for the change for the system. And this is the third redeem code. Let me quickly give it to you guys. ATPTUJPP53QH. Here is the... Here's the code. Where did my message go? Oh, here we go. Let me quickly claim the last coupon. Yep, cock. It works. All right, we can find out about the next part of the stream. That's gonna be it for today's stream, it seems like. Oh, before we go. Wait. Before they go, or before we go, make sure that you stay here until the end of the stream. We're almost over, but I'm gonna be doing a giveaway, okay? So, for those of you who came for a giveaway, they might be wondering, where's the giveaway? I'm doing the giveaway after the stream, okay? Okay, after the stream. Anyways.
사실 방송의 끝에 유저분들이 깜짝 놀랄 서프라이즈가 준비되어 있습니다. 자, 화면을 보실까요?
Inazuma. They just said that this is gonna be a surprise for the viewers, but they didn't tell us when they're gonna release Inazuma, right? Okay, that's nice. That's really nice. This is a Japanese theme, right? Alright. Yeah, that's Inazuma. That's Inazuma. It looks so pretty. Yep, cock. Yep, cock. It was actually really nice. Alright, that's it for their stream. And let's get to our... let's get back to our stream. Sorry about that. I need to do a wrap-up for the video, of course. And I need to be, Sorry, guys. I need to be, What is it called? I need to be the notepad guy. Alright, so today we talked about... My brain is fucking fried. Give me a second. So we talked about the new monsters. There's three new heroes. Well, not really three new heroes, but I would say three banners. We had three banners. So Zhongli banner, Yula banner, and then we had Yanfei. We don't know where Yanfei is gonna go, dude. Probably Yanfei is gonna go to fucking Zhongli banner. I'm gonna be pissed. They did that, right? They did that to us. Two 5-star, one rerun, plus Yanfei. Yanfei is going to Zhongli, I think. Yeah, Yanfei is going to be a 4-star. So there's 4-star. Yeah, Yanfei is in a Zhongli banner. Yeah, that's what I thought, dude. Fucking shit, man. MiHoYo is like freaking us over. I hate that. Why do they do that? Rosaria was in Child banner, and fucking... Yanfei is in Zhongli banner. I have Zhongli at C6. It's... Oh my god, I hate it so much. Anyways, scan banner again. Yeah, we were able to see the Inazuma. Now, housing system. This is fucking pog. This is really nice. And then we also saw another character than Yanfei. Yes. I just forgot what. Holy crap. You know what? Let's do this later. We can talk about this later. Alright? So, how about the giveaway? How can we enter the giveaway? First, if you're just watching my stream, that's totally fine. You're gonna get the same chance to win the giveaway. So, no worries. Okay? But first, let's go over to Twitch. We can... draw for the winner. It's a lot better system that we got there. So For those of you who's looking for a very nice community to join for Discord, you can look for other people to play with. You can also ask for ways. You can also ask for like ask a lot of questions. So my Discord channel. Let me give you the link for that. It's all. Here is the Discord. And then I'll see you guys on Twitch. Alright, I hope you guys win some giveaways. I'll be doing a lot today. Alright, thank you very much for stopping by today, and I'll see you on Twitch. Adios. Yo, what's up everyone? Welcome to Twitch. On Twitch, we can listen to a lot of DMCA songs. Like this. What is this? Is that a DMCA? Guys, thank you very much.